Our world is changing rapidly and profoundly. The changed world and the rise of Asia present unique opportunities for NUS to make a quantum leap to become a leading global university. We have what it takes to succeed.
Thank you. Dear graduates, congratulations. You are about to graduate from one of the world's top engineering schools. My colleagues and I are proud of your achievements, and we share your joy in this celebration. Your graduation marks an important milestone in your journey of lifelong learning. In the last few years, we have groomed you with the knowledge and skills to solve complex problems. While the world continues to face stresses from factors such as climate change, pollution, and resource depletion, technology is evolving faster than ever to provide new solutions and lifestyle choices for society. As engineers, you are well placed to take on these challenges, and we are confident that you will be able to use your analytical skills to derive rigorous and holistic solutions. You can make an impact in transforming the way things are done today and improve the quality of life in our community. Be bold to try out new ideas and use your design thinking skills to derive innovative solutions. Do remember to spend some time to reflect on your role in society and embrace social justice in the engineering solutions you are providing. Stay connected with your classmates through our alumni network. We also look forward to seeing you back in the faculty and perhaps help us groom our future engineers. I wish you all the very best, and once again, my heartiest congratulations.
My colleagues and I convey our warmest congratulations to the Electrical Engineering and Computer Engineering graduating classes of 2013. Commencement Day marks the beginning of a new phase in your life, and we share your joy and excitement as you look forward to building up a successful and fulfilling career as a professional electrical or computer engineer. Electrical engineering and computer engineering are at the heart of the technologies that enable us to sense, communicate, power, control, and actuate all the machinery, appliances, and gadgets that have significantly transformed our living and working environments to the current states that we enjoy. Over the last 5 decades, relentless advances in electronic technologies have made computers more powerful, much smaller and cheaper, and these in turn have had very profound impact on almost every aspect of modern day life, including how we communicate with one another, how global trade is transacted, how we entertain ourselves, how we commute and travel. In the decades ahead, electronics and computers will continue to make tremendous impact and contribute to the continued progress of humanity. They will be the heart of the systems that will control the efficient operation of the critical infrastructure and services of future dense urban cities, power the electric vehicles that run on our roads, electric ships that ply our shipping routes, and electric planes that fly above us. They will give us multimedia interactions that are so rich that our cyber and physical spaces will merge seamlessly, and they will advance biomedical devices and systems to the level that we could indeed be developing the bionic man or woman. Thus, the best is yet to be for the electrical or computer engineer who has the passion, drive, and technical capability to continue to learn and keep up with the rapid advances that these fields will continue to make. We trust that you can be that electrical or computer engineer with the solid fundamental grounding that we have provided you in the last 4 years. And we will be pleased to continue to partner you in your exciting journey ahead. As our alumnus now, we hope that you will stay engaged with us, read our newsletter to stay informed of our developments and achievements, come back to visit during our annual Alumni Homecoming event, attend our seminars and continuing education courses to stay updated on the latest technologies, and contribute to the further development of your alma mater. Thank you and best wishes.
Dear graduating class of 2013, my heartiest congratulations. I know that it has been 4 grueling years, but you have succeeded. The education and training you have received in these 4 years will hopefully prepare you for greater things as you step into the real world. I would like to share with you 4 words which I hope will help you along the way. The first word is bold. Someone once said, "The greatest barrier to success is the fear of failure." As you journey on, my encouragement to you is to be bold and attempt new things. Do not be afraid of failure. Let your creativity and ideas surface and have the courage to develop them. The second word is enthusiasm. I quote from Ralph Emerson. He said, "Nothing great was ever achieved without enthusiasm. I urge you to use your youthful vigor to your advantage. Let your passion and excitement exude out in your work and communication. Enthusiasm is contagious, an important quality in leadership." The third is substance. Amongst other things, a person with substance is someone who has principles and strong moral values. The hallmark of his or her character is integrity. Be one and you will certainly stand out among the crowd. The final word is teamwork. In this day and age, complex problem requires a multidisciplinary solution. As such, a team approach is necessary. Nowhere is more evident than in the field of bioengineering. In your course, you have been trained to work in teams. Therefore, you know what it takes to succeed. I urge you to continue to hone this skill. Professor Bill George from Harvard Business School, writing about criteria for choosing a leader, said that authentic leaders are team builders known for their character, substance, and integrity. It leaves me to wish you every success in your future endeavors and do your best.
Good evening. I'm very pleased to extend my heartiest congratulations to each and every graduate this year, especially to those from our BTech program. We all know that it's really difficult to work and study at the same time. The effort needed to balance work, study and family is non-trivial. Tonight, you can all be very proud that your efforts have paid off and you have graduated from NUS. Your future is bright. An NUS degree is highly coveted and well recognized in Singapore and elsewhere. Your employers will value what you have learned. Last but not least, I want to offer my congratulations to your families. Without the strong family support over the several years it takes to do this degree, it would be well nigh impossible to achieve what you have done. I wish you all the very best in your future endeavours. Thank you.
Today marks a very special day for the Singapore MIT Alliance as we bear witness to the graduation of 20 of our PhD students. Today is a celebration of your dedication and commitment to lifelong learning, culminating with the commencement ceremony to celebrate your achievements and your new and exciting journey. You know that it is going to be tough out there in this hard economy, but I have high hopes for every one of you. By getting an excellent education at SMA, you have built a strong and resilient foundation. And if you work hard, persevere, and leave yourself open to opportunities, you'll do great. I urge you that in the pursuit of success, don't forget to give back to society as you continue to learn and grow. Finally, today, more than any other day, remember to be grateful. Express your gratitude particularly to your parents, professors, and fellow students, for they have helped to bring you to your threshold of life. Stay engaged with SMA and the university and keep alive the precious memories of your time with us. To the class of 2013, I congratulate you on a wonderful start. Go and do SMA proud.
On behalf of the faculty and administration of the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and as the MIT co-director of the Singapore MIT Alliance, my warmest congratulations and best wishes to you all who have earned doctorate degrees from NUS and NTU under the SMA program. You have successfully completed a program and received an education that embodies the very best that Singapore and MIT has to offer. This is a remarkable accomplishment indeed, and one which MIT, NUS, and NTU, and the extended SMA family are truly proud to be a part of. Looking back over the past years, you have excelled under pressure and distinguished yourself by your dedication, perseverance, and hard work. The degree you receive today gives evidence that you have achieved all this. It also gives proof that you are prepared and now poised to go far and make great accomplishments in the years ahead. The SMA program has given you the knowledge and skills to be a technically grounded leader and to impact the world through your dedication and service. And most importantly, your SMA education has empowered you to think creatively and differently, to face and overcome challenges that others avoid, to take greater but worthy risks. And as American poet Robert Frost once wrote, to take the road less traveled and make all the difference because of it. In short, we have very great expectations of what you will go on to do. And I know we will not be disappointed. I wish you the very best in your personal and career journeys ahead. Please do stay in touch through the SMA alumni community so that we can continue and strengthen our friendship in the years ahead. Good luck and Godspeed.
my parents were pretty worried about me spending so much time in students' union activities. I was vice president of the students' union, editor of the undergrad, and so on. But eventually, when they found that I was making fairly good grades, they stopped chasing me about my involvement in students' union activities.
So we spent 48 hours at engineering, I think it was E4. So the group of us, four of us, we went there. We arrived about 48 hours before the deadline, thinking that, you know, we're the only guys who have only 48 hours to complete this. And then when we got there, it turns out that all our classmates were all there.
Definitely my social work friends, like when you face certain problems and they'll be there for you. And you know, sometimes when workloads are crazy, we just spur each other on and encourage each other lah.
My hostel, Prince George's Park, and I made many friends from different faculty.
A lot of hills, because that's what we always say when you walk from point A to point B, you have to really climb a lot of hills. It's the scenery that really sets the tone for when I talk about NUS.
That time when I was a student, it was a very different Singapore, very different university. That was in the early 60s, and I was a law student. Most of my student life was at the Bukit Timah campus, which of course had fewer buildings at that time. And since I was involved in students' union work, we had a students' union house where I practically worked and lived, or as the term used then was, we squatted there, you know, day in and day out. And that almost was my home, so to speak, during the 4 years I was there. Those were uncertain times for the university, for Singapore, Malaya or Malaysia. What was going to be the future of Singapore? It was uncertain. And together with that, what was the future of the university? In those days, we had the fun aspect, that is, organizing activities, sports. We organized the first Rag and Flag Day in my time. But we also had the serious stuff, which is working with the students' union representatives on Nanyang, Nanta Students' Union, on matters concerning the future of Singapore. And we also had serious discussions with the students' union representatives in Malaysia. We forged many close friendships, which we kept up even after graduation.
My education in NUS, I was trained as an electrical engineer, but I would say the most significant part of my education in NUS is the part that enabled me to cross from being an engineer, being a science-oriented person, to really think about business issues. So for example, I spent a lot of my time during my NUS days, I participated in the NOC program, the NUS Overseas College program, whereby we interned for a year and studied overseas, as well as, for example, participated in many programs such as the Technopreneurship Minor, the Startup at Singapore Business Plan competition, of which we actually participated for four times. So through those experiences, it enabled me to really cross over from being an engineer to think about how do we create a new product, how do we innovate with technology, how do we create a business out of new technology. And I think that forms the fundamental cornerstone of what we learn to use. Often in Singapore, as you know, we often chase after grades and chase after performance and so on. But NUS has always this distinct advantage for me that allows me to be flexible about what I learn.
Since young, I have always visualized myself to be in NUS. The main reason would be, I think, because of the prestige, lah. I mean, you know, because it's the National University of Singapore, right?
We have so many opportunities for students, and I was so sure that this was where I wanted to be because it could help me grow not only academically, but also as a person.
So I've actually been on NUS Overseas College into Stockholm. So I spent 1 year working in a startup company in Stockholm.
I chose Shanghai. I did research, online social media research, and I was given the opportunity to work directly with the founders of the company. So I learned a lot in terms of how to build a startup.
I was in NUS ULC, stands for University Lifeguard Corps. And to me, life saving is about helping a person in need, volunteering your time to be ready when a person needs help and actually stepping forward to help.
There's this youth expedition project that I've been to. We went to India, whereby we worked with children from the slums. Initially when we went, we wanted to, you know, impart skills by, you know, teaching them English, math, science and all those. But at the end of the day, they are the ones who teach us so many things about life.
I've made a lot of friends through my courses that I teach in NUS Life Saving. And it's very interesting because that's where I met my girlfriend as well.
Graduation day is the beginning of a whole new chapter of my life.
Finally!
Freedom.
Graduating from university is graduating from 15 years of education.
I feel prepared, that's the first thing, and also excited.
You know, being a graduate, yes, gives me the confidence to just face my challenges.
There's a distinct difference being in school, which you are giving a set goal of exams and so on, to graduating, whereby now you're setting your own goals. Now you decide what to do with your life for the next 40 years.
So I think we should also pursue our dreams.
Be willing to try something new.
Don't stop learning.
The most important thing I think I've learned over the last 6 years is to find meaning in everyday life. Whether it is in work or in other parts of life.
I think every individual has to work out for himself or herself. What you want to do with your life. I think the university then and now gives an individual first-rate education. But my advice is to seize the opportunities to forge that much more connections with the university and with your former colleagues. And it'll stand you in very good stead.
University education goes far beyond the training of the mind. It is about the friendships and experiences that shape our character and values. It is about a community that values new ideas, celebrates diversity, and recognizes achievement in the broader sense of the word. For the graduating class of 2013, you have been a vital part of the richness of our community. We have watched with pride how you have blossomed and grown, and we are so happy to celebrate your graduation today together with your parents and family. I wish you all the very best in the path that you choose to pursue. Always remember that you remain a valued part of our community as our NUS alumni, and that NUS will always be here for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony is about to begin. Please turn off your mobile phones or switch them to silent mode. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
I declare open a ceremony for the presentation of graduates in the school in the Singapore MIT Alliance and the Faculty of Engineering.
Ladies and gentlemen, on 4th June 2013, the National University of Singapore conferred the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws upon Mr. Lee Kuan Yew, former minister mentor and senior advisor to the Government of Singapore Investment Corporation, Republic of Singapore. The following is a recorded excerpt on the conferment ceremony for Mr. Lee that was held at the Istana.
From its inception, our university has had a rich and distinguished tradition of service to Singapore, not just supporting but actively catalyzing and driving economic growth and societal advancement for our country. This tradition of service requires us to go beyond providing our graduates with technical strengths, but also a strong sense of the attitudes, character, and qualities that have been crucial in Singapore's success in the past, and which are perhaps even more vital for our continued advancement into the future. This evening, NUS is truly honoured that Mr. Lee Kuan Yew has graciously agreed to accept the Honorary Doctor of Laws from our university. This award recognises Mr. Lee's unique and remarkable achievements in leading Singapore from the third world to the first, and for his standing as a highly respected international statesman and a global visionary. However, there can also be no better person who exemplifies the personal attributes that would inspire and energize our students, graduates, and broader community in NUS beyond, as we seek to thrive in a more complex and volatile world. We all do recognize that the gathering together of so many remarkable qualities in one person is an extremely rare event. Yet there remain important insights for each of us. For myself personally, it is the powerful and constructive balance that Mr. Lee has managed to achieve that is most impressive, and which can help illuminate our own thinking and action as we grapple with complex issues in the course of work and lives. Mr. Lee is a truly deep thinker who cuts through wildly complex issues with precision and clarity. Yet Mr. Lee is also an intensely pragmatic leader. The acceptance of evidence and sound theory as a basis for good governance, without being entrapped by rigid frames of thinking and action, was a dimension which Mr. Lee truly excelled in, and in which he was once again well ahead of his time.
Today, I would like to say just a few words about Mr. Lee Kuan Yew as a lawyer, and the role that law played in his vision for Singapore. The basic facts are well known. In the course of an education disrupted by the Second World War, Mr. Lee graduated in 1949 with a starred first-class honours in law from Cambridge. Mr. Lee might have pursued a career at the English Bar, but he returned to Singapore in 1950 to practice law. His early clients were often trade unions and associations, meaning that he earned considerably less than he could have as a lawyer. When the cause was worthy and the clients needy, he waived his fees entirely. In 1955, he set up a law firm, Lee & Lee, together with his brother and his wife, Madam Kwa Gyok Chu. The firm is now one of Singapore's leading practices. But politics was Mr. Lee's true calling. Though he did not practice law as such after leaving Lee & Lee, Singapore's subsequent transition from third world to first owes much to his embrace of the rule of law. The foundations of Singapore's role as a financial centre, he later wrote, were the rule of law, an independent judiciary, and a government that was competent, stable, and honest. As Prime Minister for a generation, he oversaw Singapore's traumatic birth and extraordinary rise. Underpinning all of this is the order and security that makes such prosperity possible. To pick just one measure, in the most recent World Justice Project report on the rule of law, Singapore was ranked first in the world for order and security and first in Asia for civil and criminal justice. Today, Singapore stands not only as a testament to what can be built through vision and industry, it is also testimony to the importance of law in creating the conditions for such a vision to be realised. Mr. Chancellor, few people are so closely identified with the entire history of a country as Mr. Lee Kuan Yew is with Singapore. Few people have had such an impact not only on a nation's development, but also on its character. That impact stretches far beyond Singapore, as the testimonials I recited earlier and countless more demonstrate. Mr. Chancellor, Lee Kuan Yew has made Singapore his life's work. His success launched a country, inspired a continent, and earned admiration from around the world. Mr. Chancellor, may it please you to confer on Mr. Lee Kuan Yew the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon Mr. Lee Kuan Yew the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws.
Congratulations, Dr. Lee. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Chairman, NUS Board of Trustees, Mr. Wong, Ngit, Liong, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I am extremely happy to present Mr. Peter Ho as our guest speaker today. Always humble, Mr. Peter Ho refers to his job title as technical manager. But we all know that he is no ordinary manager. In 2006, he co-founded the company Hope Technique with another NUS mechanical engineering alumnus, Michael Liong. They were later joined by two more friends from NUS engineering, Jeff Tang and Ng Kiang Leung. Since then, the company specializing in high performance engineering and prototype engines for the Singapore military as well as civil defense, has never ceased to ring in the news, with the latest being a successful bid for a multi-million dollar job with French aerospace giant, the European Aeronautic Defense and Space Company, or EADS. For Peter, the most enjoyable thing in the world is to tool around with mechanical parts and coming up with workable solutions. Even when he was 5 years old, he had already attempted to build a working sewing machine with a Meccano construction set. Naturally, race cars with their engines, nuts and bolts hold a lot of passion for him too. So it was not surprising that Peter was a member of an enterprising and adventurous team who tried to put together a car in 2001, targeting it as an entry for the FSAE competition at Michigan. After 2 years of hard work, the car was finally ready to roar with Peter at the helm. Unfortunately, the car couldn't make it to the competition due to insufficient funds. That didn't dampen Peter's spirit one bit. Even after he graduated, he kept close contact with the FSAE team at NUS. He also realized his dream to pursue professional motorsports by securing a job at the British Touring Car Championship with Team Petronas. After a year's stint in the UK, he returned to Asia as chief engineer to the Asian Touring Car Championship campaign. And then, of course, history began for Hope Technique. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our guest speaker, Mr. Peter Ho.
Chairman, NUS Board of Trustees, Mr. Wong, Liong, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Today, you complete what you started about 16 years ago. It started the very first day you went to kindergarten. I don't think you remember that day. And ever since then, you have fought hard and well to survive the continuous tests and examinations that have tried to filter you out from getting to this very point where you sit today. The road has been long, late nights, mugging, chasing your tutorials, copying them, lab reports, the works. Sometimes you understood what you're doing and you did very well. Sometimes you memorized it and you just regurgitated it out for the exams. No matter, well done. But as you walk out of these doors in a short while, please let me ask you this question. Where do you go from here? You see, after your PSLE, there was the O levels. And then the A levels. And then a lot of exams in NUS. So what is your next milestone? For the first time in your life, I ask that you stop listening to all the advice, demands, recommendations around you, and dig deep to answer this simple question now. What do you want in your life when you wake up on a Monday morning when you are 50 years old? On one polar extreme could be the image of a highly successful leader jumping into an exotic car with money oozing out of your ears. Another could be having 3 kids and a spouse and taking them out for a picnic on a Monday morning. You could be doing the job that you really enjoy, that is the passion and your love, or perhaps you'll be enduring a terrible boss and horrific colleagues simply because the money is good. For every scenario, there exists another which is diametrically opposite and an infinite number between these choices. And in this confusion, you must choose now. What? What do you want? By when? Where will you be doing it? In Singapore? Who is a question not just of your spouse, but also who you will have surrounding you at that point in your life? Now, those are the really easy questions. Here's the tough one. Why? It is difficult to answer this question, and it's very easy to lie to yourself repeatedly through your life. It's a simple way around it. Ask yourself why 5 times in a row. I'll try myself. Why did I become an entrepreneur? Because I wanted to be in control of my engineering career. Why? Because I like engineering. And I like to do wacky engineering that nobody would let me do and actually pay me at the end of the month. Why? Because I get bored easily, am stubborn, and want to have fun every day at work. Why? Because I'm not that smart, and if put side by side with other engineers, many from your batch itself, I'll be proven to be a bad engineer. And so I decided that if I can't beat them, I'll change the way the game was played. And why did I want to win? Because I want a comfortable life that I can still have fun living. So, when everything is crystallized, then you end off with the question of how. This is the battle plan that you will have to achieve your goal. Everyone must dare to dream. Dream big, but dream clear. Then you go and break your back to make your dream a reality. How will tell you how your career will start, the dirty, grimy entry job you will take and endure so that you will learn the ropes, so that as the CEO of an MNC one day, everyone will know that you really know your stuff. How will also be the reason why you turn down the attractive overseas job posting so that you can watch your children grow up. So you enter the working world after today with a plan in your mind, so clear that you even know when you're going to sneeze next. Well done. Until you bump into an old friend 10 years later and you go home depressed. He or she has a brand new Ferrari and you have a baby pram. His car screams like a thoroughbred Italian banshee and your baby screams and screams all day, all night. And you go home depressed. Stop. You have your plan and he or she has his. The grass will always be greener on the other side of the fence, and whatever makes you think that your peers are not envious of your life. The Ferrari may be really fast, but have you ever seen the look of parents when their kids take their first steps? Not as fast as a Ferrari, but they remember that, and the car just disappears when the COE runs out. Yes, the plan will change a little along the way, but be very aware why. Consistency is a virtue you must learn to have, and most importantly, in how you deal with yourself, else you will be your own biggest hater. Now, I am an uncle to this next generation that you are. My friends have achieved the government quota of three children already. An old friend is a member of parliament. A cooler friend is a driver in Formula One. Some friends have already become stewards of industry. Many of them have become scary bosses that chew up fresh hires on a Monday morning. As you leave the rank of student, let me be the first to tell you that you are the generation that will replace everyone older than you. I say that again. The future is yours. You are there to replace those in front of you. So job vacancies of every description are now open and hiring. Dream your dream, make your plan your own plan, and go make it happen for yourself. I congratulate all of you on your commencement, and now the party we call life gets even more fun. Thank you.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degree has earlier been conferred. Singapore MIT Alliance, Doctor of Philosophy. Aswarya Sri Hadran. Chakadish Sankara. Jie Gengjie. Li Suhui Sophia. Li Yan. Liu Chang Chang. Navin Kumar Bala. Niha Bao. Nguyen Ngoc Hien. Nguyen Xuan Sang. Oma Pulio Swaminathan Rajamouli. Pokodi Pania Salvam. Ravindranath Pradeep Anand. Xi Yuan. Wu Yingting. Yin Lu. Zhang Bo.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have already been conferred. Faculty of Engineering, Doctor of Philosophy, Chu Sui Jin. Chu Sui Guang Yu Jin. Huang Li San. Huang Xue Lian. Ke Qing Qing. Ko Ting Ting Andrew. Li Kang Le. Liu Hua Jun. Liu Yan Cheng. Muhammad Muhammad Anwar Hussein. Mehdi Jaffrey Zadi. Chen Li Peng. Xin Yang. Wang Yingxiao. Wang Zitao. Yang Yang. Yuan Du. Yang Yang. Master of Engineering, Che Kit Min Kevin. Wei Rui Qi. Master of Science, Material Science and Engineering, and Wasik Da. Go Zijian. Hu Wei. Li Wei Ming. Li Mo. Ma Xin. Sumandu Chakrati. Soba Konki Konkuti. Wankata Mani Kanda Rajidran. Wong Bing Fong. Yi Si Lan. Zhang Jie. Zhang Yi. Double degree program, Bachelor of Engineering, Material Science and Engineering, Bachelor of Science. Xiao Wen. Pa Ka Cha. Bachelor of Engineering, Material Science and Engineering. Winner of the Li Guangyo Gold Medal, AES Gold Medal, Huang Tang Zhou. Winner of the Materials Research Society Singapore Medal, Chung Hui Min. USP Scholar, Xiang Xiang Xu. Ong Jian Chou. Caroline Khoi Phik Im. Chin Mei Ting Rebecca. Cha Pei Ying. Cha Zhou Heng. Chiang Wei Kyung, Jonathan. Chung Sek Ting. Christy Antu Renata. Huang Qing Li. King Chung Chia, Claudia. Ko Tak Fung. Li Xinhua, Anna. Liang Zhiwei. Li Qing King, Kenneth. Lim Rong Jian Finiang. Lin Ziyang. Lu Pei Liang. Lu Qing Yi. Ma Mei Qi. Matilda Tan Yi Xuan. Ng Yu Ting. Yan Long Fu. O Jin Quan Eugene. Ren Yue. Se Tian Long, Alex. Suma Sundaram, Anita. Song Jinghui. Tan Jie Long, Kenneth. Tan Xi Hua, Sharia. Tai Zili. Titsin Ping Gabriel. Wang Hua Xing. Wang Ji. Wang Hui Ping, Bridget. Wang Xiong Qi. Chou Zhu Ming.
Sorry, my surname is Cao. It matters for me.
Thank you. Qin Yi Liang. Michael Lava Timina. Muhammad Yazid bin Ruslan. Wang Suquan.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have earlier been conferred. Double degree program, Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering and Bachelor of Business Administration. Winner of the Micron Prize, the Asian Congress of Fluid Mechanics Book Prize, the ISTP9 Fluid and Thermo Book Prize, Lim Ziyu. Lao Yu Song. Ho Jianming Dexter. Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering. Winner of the Lee Kuan Yew Gold Medal, the IES Gold Medal, the ExxonMobil Medal, and the Micron Prize, Yu Chunhong. Winner of the Keppel Offshore and Marine Medal and Prize, Chi Enqing. Winner of the PEB Gold Medal, Gareth Chin Yen Ket. winner of the Micron Prize, Shui Yet Hayden. USP Scholar, Asha Bin Athli. USP Scholar, Cheng Ji Fong Maple. Aaron N. Young Ating. Alston Wong Jun Ngai. Andrade Christopher Andrew. Andre Satyawan. Andrew Ong, Wang Wenjun. Andy Christian Prasetio. Ang Eugene. Ang Swan Ping, Eric. Ang Wan Sheng, Ian. Anshul Modi. Tai En Huo. Kelvin Sutiono. Chan Chun Chiang. Chan Guan Yi. Chan Hei Leong, Terence. Chan Jian Yuan, Jimmy. Chan Yongwei. Chen Honghang. Chen Lizhen. Chen Yihui Kevin. Cheng Yen Boon, Edmund. Chok Xue Ting. Chong Guo Jian. Chiu Chuan Shen. Chia Sin Wei. Chia Wei Beng. Chia Zhenwei. Qiang Junxian, Clarence. Chin Ka Fai. Cheng Wei Quan, Desmond. Chong Ning Yun. Chong Shen Long Marcus. Chong Wilter. Chu Chun Ming. Chung Guowei. Chua Aixia. Chua Chun Hao, Jasper. Chua Hui Shan, Eunice. Chua Jie Ying. Chua Kian Yong, Kenny. Chung Wing Tai. Daud Christy Wasiman. David Raj. Deepa Kumaran, son of Krishnan Sami. Delia Chia Wan Lin. Deng Si Jia. Devendra Goyal. Dalfinch Anderson. Yongchen. Fahad Ib Azam. Faizan Abid. Fan Yichong. Fan Zihong. Feng Ruyi. Gan Liang An, Eric. Jeffrey Richard Jelly. Go Jin Hong, Alvin. Go Kay Sin. Go Lian Zhou. Go Si Hui. Go Wei Ming, Clement. Hans Anderson. Ho Hui Ping, Doran. Ho Jin Hui, Nicholas. Ho Wei Xiang. Hong Zheng Xuan, Eugene. Hun Si, Bernard. Hao Han Hong. Huang Hu Guang. Huang Shuqing. Huang Weiheng. Huang Yingchuan. Iksan Putra Ibrahim. Inigo. Ivan Surya Chayo. Jeffrey Tan Chun Ho. Johan Ananta Kayadi. John Gusti. Julius Caesar Bagus Wikasono. Kartik Kanan. Kelvin Tan Wee Ern. Q Jia Ming. Ku Yi Qing. Kui Yi Qing. Qing. Ko Chi Lin. Ko Han Lin. Ko Kai Zhen. Ko Wei Liang William. Ko Yan Tian. Ku Mingshen Julian. Kwa King King Eunice. Lai Ping Ching. Lai Yo Pin. Lam Siu Hon. Lao Shek Ki. Li Tianwei Nicholas. Li Li Qian. Li Pin Chi. Li Wei Yang. Li Xinying. Liong Yao Lin. Liao Po Jin. Liong Sai Chung. Li Hui Ming, Genevieve. Li Jian. Li Zhengrong, Eric. Li Zhong. Liao Li Ming. Liu Nian Kong. Liu Xing Yi. Lim Bi Wei. Lim Jing Xiang, Shadrach Tobiah. Lim Ke Er. Lim Sing Yong, David. Lim Tianwen Matthew. Lim Siu Fang Michelle. Lim Yiqing. Lim Yongxian. Lin Chongren. Lin Mingzhen Justin. Lin Zhongxuan. Lin Zijian. Liao Qingxiang. Liu Ying. Lo Weijie Benjamin. Lu Kiwei Jerome. Lao Junqing. Lao Pat Nguyen. Lao Pat Nguyen Liu Bo Yuan. Lao Ziwei. Lua Mingjie. Ma Zheng. Mark Derek Nadan. Mao Li Shilan Thacker. Michelle Lee Sok Hyang. Muhammad Talha Raza. Mok Ting Ling. Muhammad Farhan bin Abdul Rahman. Muhammad Hizan bin Kamis. Muhammad Shafaruddin, son of Munir. Muhammad Zuhaili bin Muhammad Said. Neo Chun Chuan. Neo Chu Ping Stephanie. Ng Chong Ping. Ng Ju San. Ng Jun Jie. Ng Peng Lung. Ng Ching Kai David. Ng Shao Kai. Ng Yan Long Nicholas. Ng Ying Xiang. Nugraha Siddhartha. Nu Hanisa Binti Hasnan. Oja Cheng. O Sien Jun Thomas.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degree has earlier been conferred. Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering. Oh Cheng Jie. Ong Jing Cheng, Nigel. Ong Kok Sin. Ong Wei Ming. Ban Kale Lee. Pang Ngun Kia. Pang Wei Ming Benjamin. Po Guan Jie. Po Wei Ping. Po Yun. Chi Chi. Qiu Guan Zhong. Qiu Li Yi. Quek Jiang Hong, Jack. Q Kwek Yong Sheng Vincent. Ryan Wee Bo Jia. Sarah Liu Ka Moon. Xia Wee Kiang. Si Hien Hien. Selva Kumar S. O. Krishna Sami. Shen Shun Singh Kenny. Shi Wen Hui. Xiao Yu Hui. Sim Chin Yung. Sim Lin Ka. Sim Lucius. Sim Yong Lim Aaron. Sri Gautam Taku Venkateswaran. Srihat Shah Vishnu Bhatt. Srivatsa Ramesh. Sugumaran Dinuraj. Suhana Binti Haris. Tan Chi Kong Kevin. Tan Chun Yu. Tan Chuen Yang Jarrett. Tan Chun Ren. Tan J. Win. Tan Jia Yang. Tan Jian Hui Gilbert. Tan Jie En Moses. Tan Kok Wee Clarence. Tan Li Chao. Tan Ming Kai. Tan Po Shun Sean. Tan Xue Ben. Tan Teck Chuan. Tan Wei Ren Darren. Tan Wen. Tan Wilson. Tan Sin Lee Stephen. Tan Yen Liang. Tan Yen Rui. Tan Ji Hua Jirina. Tang Shi Yuan. Tang Ying Peng. De Gui Gen, Freddy. De Kun Lin, Clement. De Chi Ming, Andrew. De Xian Xiet. De Han Yang, Justin. Tek Yi Sam. Teo Tian Ming. Tiong Han Long. Tham Chien Yong. Tham Kai Sheng. Theng Jing Xiong. Tian Geng Xin. Ting Yong Hao Jackson. Teng Zhi Yong Daniel. Do Le Huang Jeremy. Veluri Shuri. Vincent. Wang Chao. Wasim Sharif. William Theodore Moninka. Wong De Hao. Wong Pei Wen Janet. Wong Wai Quan Timothy Huang Wei Chuan. Wong Yi Yin Kimberly. Wu Li Ling. Xie Liang Peng. Su Su. Yam Yin Chuan, Daryl. Yang Kai Chuan. Yap Lin Jack. Yeo Jia Sheng Jason. Yong Cheng Liang. Yong Wei Long. Zia Luin Tun. Zhang Zhao Yang. Zhao Peng. Zhou Quan. Zhou Xiong. Zhuang Mingda. Alston Yap Chong Yun. Andrade Alvin Matthew. Ang Kim T. Eugene. Ang Pei Xuan. Chai Wei Cheng. Chan Tat Sheng Benjamin. Chen Hao Jin. Chong Chu Xiang, Jasper. Chong Wing Hong, Joel. Chiu Chong Yan. Chiu Fat Xiong. Chik Sheng Jie. Cho Xiang Long. Chua Li En, Stasia. Chua Ti Hong. Chua Yu Sing. Clarice Sabrina Lim Sue Ting. Fu Chi Yi. Gan Quan. Go Ying Jie, Darren. Imran B. Abdul Kader. Ko Han Seong. Kwan Wen Kin, Benjamin. Kwok Cho Hao Yao. Kwok Yao Sheng. Li Xiang Duan, Gerald. Lim Ding, LA. Lim Hui Giok. Lim Jun Long. Lim Zhao Hong. Luk Rong Hao, Joel. Lo Ji Ling, Jocelyn. Lam Si Kai, Kelvin. Madhav Kapoor. Maricelli Rani Wong. Maricel Rani Wong. Mathusan Mahendran. Muhammad Ali bin Sapingi. Muhammad Ashraf bin Muhammad Yusuf. Muhammad Rashid B. Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Hafiz bin Abdul Aziz. Muhammad Fazil bin Batha Ruthin. Muhammad Farhizam bin Salamat. Muhammad Taufik bin Muhammad Ismail. Nawaljit Singh Raya. Neo Kai Hong, Kelvin. Ng Chun Singh, Bernard. Ng Jian Long. Ngen Hun Hao, Nigel. Ong Li Pern, Ivan. Ong Zi Ming, Luke. Ao Chen Yu. Piravin B. P. Ganesan. Pun En Ming, Joel. Pulkit Agarwal. Quek Jin Long. Xia Jie Wei, Sean. Sim Wei Tao. Sun Qing Xia. Shafiq bin Ab Rahman. Tan Chin Ai. Tan Dwayne Aaron. Tan Hui Yi Tracy. Tan Jin Pei, Nicholas. Tan Mei Si. Tan Seng Ling, Donald. Tan Xuan Zheng. Tang Sung Yang Elshan. Tay Chao Si. Teo Wei Long, David. Teo Cheng Yang. Teo Peck Siang. Tung Ching Hua. Wee Li Heng. Wong Tak Fai Amos. Yamuna Rathamani. Yang Junfu. Yo Hyok Wee. Yindi Tae. Yu Kai Si, Nicodemus. Yu Zhao He. Zhu Yun Long. The valedictorian for this ceremony is Mr. Lim Zhi Yu, who graduated with the double degrees of Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering, with first class honors, and Bachelor of Business Administration with pass with merit. He is the winner of the Micron Prize, Asian Congress of Fluid Mechanics Book Prize, and ISTP9 Fluid and Thermal Book Prize. He will now deliver his speech.
Chairman, NUS Board of Trustees, Mr. Wong Ngit Liong, Technical Manager, Hope Technic Private Limited, Mr. Peter Ho Yu Chi, distinguished guests, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant good afternoon to all of you. It is a tremendous honor and privilege to be chosen to speak on behalf of the graduating class of 2013. To be nominated a valedictorian is also a great example of how someone can be both a winner and also not one at the same time. Coming to NUS has proven repeatedly to be one of the best decisions that I've made. And I would like to thank my parents for sending me here and also for supporting me throughout my 4 years of studies. My parents are convinced that I have chosen NUS for its prestigious double degree program. However, to be entirely honest, I came to NUS following a girl. So essentially, You can see this as a $26,000 deed. Graduation marks a significant milestone of our lives. And it is also one of those times where we find ourselves torn between the joy of our memories and the excitement of our future. We came to this campus 4 years ago with different backgrounds and life experiences. Today, we leave this campus as a collective unit, the graduating class of 2013, with common memories etched forever in our minds. The years spent in NUS have molded us into who we are today, individuals who are well-versed in failures. We have all gone through our share of failed experiments, failed papers, failed computing codes, and failed simulations. Ultimately, we will all make mistakes at some point or other in our lives, be it in school, in the workplace, in relationships, or even in front of thousands of people. More importantly, these experiences have trained us to accept criticism and advice, and also to learn from our mistakes. With each failure, we learn and adapt to improve ourselves. We learned that grades are not proportional to the number of books brought into an open book exam, and that grades are also not inversely proportional to the size of the words written on the cheat sheet. Now that we have graduated, this marks the end of not only our 4 years of education, but also the way of life that we have been so accustomed to. We have all proven how procrastination and indifference can not only be just big words, but also a way of life. Now, we can no longer legitimately sleep past noon and attend lectures in flip-flops and pajamas. We entered this campus 4 years ago as scared and lonely freshmen. Today, as we complete our education and leave this campus, we may feel as if we've gone a whole circle and ended up where we first started, left alone again to face the challenges of the corporate world. Our experiences in NUS, however, have transformed us into better people, better prepared in tackling problems and solving issues of the real world. We have all made tough decisions about priority. Sometimes, planning graduation trips just before the examinations was a priority. But at other times, we recognized that our education must take precedence. We also learned the importance of perseverance and devoting ourselves to doing things well. I have a quote that I'd like to share with all of you. Success is not measured by how well you fulfill the expectations of others, but by how you honestly live up to your own expectations. Success is not a place at which one arrives, but rather the spirit with which one undertakes and continues the journey. We have all written papers which we dreaded at that time, but because we endured, we can now look back bravely with pride. Because we have been true to ourselves in the pursuit of our dreams, we have earned this moment and the right to be proud of our accomplishment. However, we should also be mindful that if we do things too well, it may backfire. And you may find yourselves invited to stand in front of thousands of people and give a speech about it. The journey that we have just completed should not be measured by distance nor time, but instead, the numerous friendships nurtured along the way. Life in NUS has given us our fair share of tears and joy. Life without friends will be like thermodynamics without steam tables. To the graduating class of 2013, today is a day of celebrations. In the immortal words of Robert Browning, "The best is yet to be." I offer you my sincerest congratulations and wish you the very best that life has to offer. Thank you.
Dear graduates, as we come to the end of today's ceremony, we would like to extend our heartiest congratulations to you on your commencement. We warmly welcome you to the NUS alumni family.
I now declare this ceremony closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem.
As we remain standing, my fellow graduates, this is a proud day for all of us and for our parents and loved ones who have supported us in our journey here. Therefore, before we leave this hall, let us take this opportunity to show our appreciation for our family and friends with a round of applause. Please join me in this gesture. Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2013!